with NMC today, I would like to welcome all the employer groups, all the members of NMC, everybody that has logged in. Thank you for joining us. Today I'm going to be showing you guys a very easy recipe. It's a tinned fish and spinach shakshuka. I'm sure we all have tinned fish at home. Here I have some tinned fish. This is just one tin of tinned fish. I'm actually guilty because I always used to remove the bones, and I think at the last session they said I must not remove the bones because it has calcium in it. I have olive oil here, extra virgin, about 2 tablespoons, white cheddar cheese, some mixed herbs, and then I have a tablespoon of garlic here, and some green pepper and onions, 2 tomatoes that I've just diced up, and some spinach, and then some eggs over there, and then the spices I'm gonna use is just some black pepper and paprika for that nice smoky flavor, as well as the color. So let's get started. The first thing I do, okay, I'm gonna switch on the stove. About, I would say, medium to high heat. Don't test it with your hands like I'm doing. These are chef's hands. So I'm gonna heat up some oil in the pan. This is about 2 tablespoons of extra virgin olive oil, dietitian approved. And then I'm gonna add my onions. Saute that. The way you know onions are done cooking is when it becomes translucent and it doesn't smell so raw anymore. So we're gonna do that for like maybe what, 4 minutes, 5 minutes. Turn the heat a little bit lower. It's already starting to smell not so raw anymore. Then I'm gonna go in with the garlic. Garlic just gives food that, I don't know, just that extra nice flavor. And then I'm gonna go in with the green pepper. I'm not gonna cook the green pepper for long because I want the dish to have that little bit of crunch. Then I'm gonna go in with the tomatoes. What I'm going for here is for the tomatoes to become a bit almost paste-like before I add in the fish and the spinach. I like to add my salt and my black pepper right after I add the tinned fish because tinned fish is already quite salty. I think I'm gonna add the paprika now and the mixed herbs. That's also about a teaspoon to about 2 teaspoons. Get that flavor really going. It smells so nice as well. Okay, I think the tomatoes have cooked down the way I wanted to. Okay, I'm gonna turn the heat a bit lower again. And then I'm gonna add the fish, the tinned fish. I'm gonna just mesh, not really completely mesh, but just break up the fish a bit. And then mix it around just until everything is incorporated nicely. Yeah, and then we're gonna go in with the spinach. Spinach is really healthy. It's green. So if it's green, it's healthy. So I'm not gonna use all the spinach. I used maybe about 2 cups, 2.5 cups. I'm gonna let it wilt down. You're gonna see just now once the spinach has wilted. This dish is good for breakfast. It's good for brunch. You can have it for lunch. I mean, I have breakfast for dinner sometimes, so it's good for that as well. Black pepper is my favorite spice to cook with. Black pepper and garlic. I can't cook without those two. So I think about a teaspoon maybe. You can personalize the recipe as well. Add some fresh chili if you want. add any other veggies, make it hearty, add some broccoli, you know, cauliflower. I think a lot of veggies would really work nicely in here. But I like to do spinach because it's quite fast. I think I'm gonna give it a few more minutes, say 2-3 more minutes. And then I'm gonna do the eggs now. For what makes this dish a shakshuka. So what you wanna do is create little wells where the eggs are gonna sit. Let's hope I crack the eggs perfectly. Né? But if you don't, you're not cooking for Gordon Ramsay or whoever, so just hope for the best. More for presentation, perfect. Number one, perfect. Number two, perfection. Number three, another perfect one. Okay, I'm saying perfect because the yolks did not crack. So the eggs are in, the yolks are perfect, they are sitting perfectly. So I'm gonna season the eggs just a little bit. I think I'm gonna move it to the lower heat. So now we're just gonna wait for the eggs to cook. I think the eggs are cooking really nicely. It takes about 8 to 12 minutes. Yeah, so I think this is done. So I'll turn off the heat now. The dish is done. You have a beautiful dish that looks like this with some eggs. And the runny part of the egg is actually gonna be like a sauce for the entire dish. So then you try to scoop it out as best as you can so that you don't destroy the egg, the beautiful egg. You can garnish this with some fresh herbs, some chili. You can put on a bit of feta. Ah, I forgot the cheese. Oh my goodness. The cheese is supposed to go on top of the thing and melt and But I'm gonna just do it now here. But don't be like me, please. Put it on, when you put the lid on, put the cheese over, not on top of the eggs, but around the eggs. Close the lid, have it melt down nicely so you have that cheese pool when you serve it. So you can serve it with some fresh chili. I'm gonna use some parsley here as well. And it scatters nicely everywhere. Good. And I think we are done. There we have it, guys. Thank you for tuning in.